be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. He also told them this parable. Can the blind lead the blind? Will they not both fall into a pit? Amen. Let me tell you something. This is the day and the hour, amen, that you don't need to be judging people. You need to keep your mouth off of people and their things. I mean, that you're going to see many people in front of you. I have them. I have friends, amen, people that I've known all pretty much all my life, amen. And for some reason, things just go distance, and all you can do is just pray for them. Amen. I mean, you got people, amen. I got people that I'm even trying to work with, amen. And, you know, I've known some of these people. You can know these people for a long time. You may not know them. You know of them. Amen. There's a difference between knowing people and knowing of them. Amen. And so, you know, you're around these individuals, and it's like a struggle. Amen. Because they're challenging. And, you know, some people can't forget about the past. Amen. I remember driving down the road one day, and I was going in an area where I grew up. And I had this convertible, you know, this hard top convertible. And I'm riding through this neighborhood, and I hear somebody yell my name out. And, you know, I pull over, you know. I don't know why, I just pulled over. And, you know, the young man, well, you know, he put his hand on my door handle. I said, man, you better back up, get your hand off my door handle. And he was like, well, you know, what's going on, you know, and this and that. And he was just talking to me. And I said, hey, listen, man, you know, when we were 10 and 11 and 12, that's one thing. Amen. But you know, now we grown. And I had not seen that guy in 20, 30 years. Now, some people say that I didn't have to be like that and so on and so on. But get what, this is what I'm saying. People get familiar with you based on your past. But your advice taking you to a new place. So you can't judge these people. Sometimes what you got to do, and matter of fact, that particular individual, every time I seen him, I had to buy him food or give him whatever that he needed. Amen. Never said no to him. Amen. Now he's got his life together. But the whole moral story is there are people that are placed in your life from your past that are challenges. They're a challenge to you because the things that they believe that they're delivered from, they're still stuck with it. They're still stuck in the past, even by the way they talk to you. Amen. Their mannerism and the different things. And they don't understand because your advisor showed it to them that guess what? You know, you know that individual, amen, Jehovah could use that guy to be my deliverance as well as me, you know, be something that could help them to get to their deliverance. Amen. But people like to put themselves over you, you know, because you were popular when you were 10, 11, 12, and 13. Guess what? You know, you done got old now and you're not as popular. And you still stuck in the past and you know that ain't even happening anymore. Why? Because Jehovah is doing a new thing and the meek shall inherit the earth. And you got, it's important that we know the people that we're surrounded by. Amen. I mean, you know, I was talking to somebody about this, you know, where there are people that Jehovah puts in your life to challenge you, but you can't judge them. If they're nasty, you be kind. Amen. Listen, if you got to serve them cheerfully. If you gotta work with them with excellence, from a stellar position. Amen. And that's what you do. I mean, you break that stuff up because, hey, you know, listen, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. They don't know what they said. Amen. And you can get wrapped up in that and allow that thing from the past to, you know, to come up and cause a clash. And you ain't supposed to be clashing with people, you know, because why? You the men and women of God. That's who we are. We're the men and women of God. So we understand them who they are. Amen. You know, they want to be seen. They want to be known and this and that. And they do everything to be seen. And amen. And that's the part of the enemy. But you know, when people get around you and you just show them the love of Jehovah, they're not used to that. Amen. Because people make them to be big. Amen. But in the presence of Jehovah, let's face it, all of us and all our righteousness is like filthy rags in the eyesight of Jehovah. No one is righteous, all have sinned and fallen short of the glory of Jehovah. So, you know, there's no need in being puffed up. We're all in this thing together down here until we what? Change from mortality to immortality, and we shall be as he is. So you don't pay him any mind. You just love on him. And the nastier they get, the more you love. The harder they get to work with, the more you love. And guess what? And even, you know, and I've had it where they may have, you know, where I'm like, I need prayer how to deal with this person. And I may ask somebody. And then after I ask that person and whatever, you know what? And I get to my point and I say, Father, forgive me. I repent. Because the only reason why I'm able to flow, or that I have flowed in some levels, realms, is because Jehovah allowed me to. It was no goodness of my own, lest he switches the positions like we talked about in the earlier scripture. Amen. Because I be disobedient. You know, he's telling me to show love and I show hate, or I get bitter, or I show retaliation, and Jehovah takes that position from me and gives it to them. So we want to give, amen. We want to give out of the things of Jehovah in love. In Romans 12, verses 7 through 9. If it is serving, then serve. If it is teaching, then teach. If it is to encourage, then give encouragement. If it is giving, then give generously. If it is to lead, do it diligently. It is to show mercy, do it cheerfully. Love must be sincere. Hate what is evil and cling to what is good. Amen. It's very important that, you know, we love out of the principles of Jehovah, and that we do the things of Jehovah, that we show people the love of Jehovah at all times. Amen. Whatever we do from excellence, from the things of Jehovah, from a kingdom perspective. Amen. And that's what it is. And we want to show people the things of Jehovah at every level. And let me tell you something. I don't care where you are. He gives you this day the opportunity. If you're in a bad place and you find yourself on the opposite side, change. Lest he snatches that stuff away from you, your gifts, and give it to somebody else. Lest he takes that title away from you and gives it to somebody else. Lest he takes you off the scene, amen, to go to sleep, and gives it to somebody else. Lest you be demoted and somebody else be promoted in your stead. Change. Amen. Give and it shall be given unto you. Jehovah is a good God. Amen. We serve a good God. Listen, we're almost done. In my close, let me tell you what the end of this thing looks like. In Revelations 21, verses 5 through 7. He who was seated on the throne said, I am making everything new. Then he said, write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true. He said to me, it is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. To the thirsty, I will give water without cost from the spring of the water of life. Those who are victorious will inherit all this, and I will be their God, and they will be my children. And that's what you want today, my beloved brothers and sisters, everlasting life without cost. The only thing it costs is you is your body, a living sacrifice, your yes to Jehovah, your love towards people. Jehovah, right now, I'm about to pray. Jehovah is given unto us everlasting life. Jehovah has given grace and mercy to each and every one of us. Jehovah has given us life, health, and strength. Jehovah has given us provisions. His word declares that never have I seen the righteous forsaken, nor a seed begging of food and bread. So whatever Jehovah has given unto you in great portions out of yourself, what he wants you to do today from these little words is give to someone else. He gave it to you, not for you to hoard and keep, not for you to brag and boast, not for you to be somebody big, amen, big eyes and little U's and all that kind of stuff. No. He gave that thing for you to give to somebody else. He gave it to you so that you could share it with somebody else. He gave it to you so that his kingdom would be glorified. He gave it to you to bring glory to himself. He gave it so that you could minister to somebody with help. He healed you so that you could go and pray and let somebody else get healed. He gave you your money and your bills and all that, and increase and wealth, so that you can give it to somebody else. That's why he gave it to you. He gave you salvation so that you can share it with somebody else. He gave you the Holy Spirit so that you can teach and tarry with somebody until they were endured with power from on high and got the Holy Spirit. That's why he's giving it to you. He's not giving you anything for you to sit on. He's not giving you anything for you to brag and boast. He's not giving you anything so that you can make a book or record or a CD and make money off of. That's not why he's giving it to you. See, he himself said what? He says, I'm going to give you water from the spring of life that won't cost you nothing. Huh? That's what he said. So give it to him freely. Give it to him generously. Give generously. Whenever you have a chance, give. Because there's one key word that Yahweh's concerned about, and that's others. And Father, we thank you for your word. We thank you for your word. We thank you for your word. I thank you for your word today. I thank you for your word, the power of your word, the influence of your word. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your word. Quicken me in thy word. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your word. Thank you for your holy word. Thank you for your sanctified word. Thank you for your word. Thank you for the strength of your word. Thank you for the power of your word. And Lord, we thank you for your word. Thank you for what your word's going to do today of everybody under the sound of my voice, worldwide, globally. Thank you for how your word brings peace today. Thank you for how your word brings oneness and unity. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, the Holy One. Now move by your word. Move by your word. Let your word manifest itself through the hearts and lives of your people. Everyone under the sound of my voice. Everyone under the sound of my voice. I thank you for your grace and mercy for your people. And I thank you for your word. And we move in the art of giving. I decree and declare that we become one body, giving up each other's gifts till we're all filled and full. We become broken bread. Thank you, Father. Give us this day our daily bread. And so we give bread to others. We become daily bread for others. We become the word alive for others. We become the sacrifice for others. In the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, the Holy One. And I thank you for so being sealed and done. I pray this prayer right now in the mighty name of Yeshua, the Messiah, the Holy One. It is so sealed and done upon your people. Amen and amen. Well, God bless you. That ends this episode. I'm so excited for all of you. Listen, let me tell you something. Share that with a friend. Amen. Share that with a friend. Give that to a friend. Now, we done talked about giving. Give it to a friend. Amen. Lead them and take them, direct them to the website. Direct them to not the website, but to the apps. Amen. We have that Android app at I Won't Miss Live Radio. I Won't Miss Live Radio. And we also have the iTunes app at I Won't Miss Live Radio. Amen. And guess what? The app is free. And all the messages is free. Amen. They can continue to keep hearing it. And there's a lot of good stuff on there. I mean, I believe all that Yehovah does is good. Amen. And so there's a lot of really interesting things on there. And it'll be a blessing to somebody. It's free. Amen. Just give it. Amen. Give it. Give it as many people as you can. I'm talking about giving today. I'm not asking you for money. I'm just asking you to press send and talk and give this word to somebody. Let it be a blessing to somebody else. Amen. And it can continue to do. It's very easy. It goes on their mobile phones, on their tablets, on their iPads, the iTunes. Amen. The iPhones is there. Amen. For your use. Listen, until the next time. Amen. First of all, to the next time. Shalom, Shabbat. Blessings be to you and your family. Jason, I love you. Everybody in the team, listen, I love you all. I appreciate all of you. Continue to keep fasting and praying with me. We're excited. You that are intercessors, listen, continue to keep praying with me because we're going to do this 72-hour global prayer. Amen. With pastors all over the world. And we're going to touch the heart of Yehovah for mankind. Amen. His grace and his mercy is for the people today. Amen and amen.
Declare what can wash.